2016 Harley-Davidson Softail Slim. To sell or not to sell? That is the question. All right, guys. So basically, I'm just looking for your input on whether I should keep or should I sell this beautiful 2016 Harley-Davidson Softail Slim. So if you're new to the channel or haven't seen me ride this bike in a while on past videos, let me give you some of the good points and some of the things I wish were better on this bike. So let's talk about some high points first. Let's see. It looks awesome. We can agree on that. It has an awesome color. It is in the matte black color scheme, which Harley calls denim black. And it actually was the first one on island in 2016 in this color. Actually, the only one for a couple months. So that's a pretty cool thing. Just a little bit of trivial knowledge to know that I had the first 2016 Harley Softail Slim in the matte black in Hawaii. But guys, it's super comfy. It has this this two-up, you know, sundowner seat, which gives me like good backrest so I can lean back like this. It's just like I'm in a recliner, guys. It's got these floorboards, as you can see down here, the moon shape. It's just so comfortable. I mean, my feet right now are just laid on the floorboards and leaning back. You got the support with my backrest on these handlebars that are, you know, right here. Just perfect arms reach. It's like you're not even reaching at all. It's just like you're sitting in a chair holding on. A chair that goes quick. But anyway, I love this bike. It's comfortable. It's only got 1,608 miles on it. And the reason it's, you know, I've had it 2 years, but the reason it has so low miles on it is because I had at one point four motorcycles. And then I got down to three for a while. And now I'm down to two because I am moving, which is one of the main reasons I'm looking at selling it. You know, I don't know if I want to pay for two bikes to get shipped across the Pacific. Back to the mainland, but we'll see. I mean, it's not a price thing. I can afford to ship it, obviously. It's just the fact, do I want to drag this all the way back to the mainland and risk damage? Because, you know, there's stories of people's bikes getting damaged and then fighting with insurance companies and the movers. And, you know, and I got two motorcycles, so you're doubling your trouble, basically. You know, the Honda CBR 1000RR, my Wolverine, which I love, and this Harley-Davidson Softail Slim. So that's one of the big debates, you know. Do I ship both and pay for it and keep this guy? Or do I just trade it in, or not so much trade it in, but, you know, sell it and then take my chances when I get to my next location where I'm moving, where you can ride year-round also. And the reason I'm not going to know where I'm moving yet is because I want you guys to guess. It's a warm weather state that you can ride year-round. You know, there's a handful of them back in the U.S. on the mainland, and I want you guys to guess what it is. So take your best guess and leave which state you think I'm moving to next in the comments below. A couple more things I like about this bike. Well, like I said, I like how the looks one, but just the look right here, it's clean. It's got the Hollywood style handlebars here, the BMX style, old school. It doesn't have the big giant fairing like the, you know, street glides and road glides. However, I am thinking about getting street glides. Look at this one out here in the top left. And it was tempting when I was out of town for work on a business trip, and I went to the Harley dealer and I saw that beautiful bike, and I was like, man, that might be what I upgrade to after the Softail Slim. So there's an idea for you. But it's also funny how I just contradicted myself saying I love the clean look of this with no big front fairing, and then I like the street glide. So there you go, guys. I mean, I'm all over the place. I love all bikes, though. But that's why I own sport bikes, and that's why I own cruisers, because I love all bikes. And if I could, I'd have dirt bikes and, you know, all kinds of ADV adventures. You name it. Four-wheelers, go-karts. I want it all, man. But you got to be practical, you know, with the time I have to ride and do all this stuff like motovlog and edit videos as a hobby in my spare time. You just got to be careful and balance your acts. Which goes back to, do I sell this, guys? We'll go into some negatives real quick. First, it doesn't have the big fairing and windshield. So you get all this air just blowing into you, especially when you're up to speed on like the highways. It's not so bad on these roads because I'm not going fast. But I wear a full face helmet to kind of counteract that. But man, it would be nice, especially if it's raining, it's just pounding you. You know, and even a sport bike has a little windshield, right? And on my BMW S1000RR, if y'all remember that, I actually had the zero gravity double bubble windshield, and that actually came up pretty high. And it gave some good wind direction protection, whatever you want to call it. Another thing I don't like about this bike, it really doesn't have any storage at all. I mean, none. Less than my sport bikes. I bought the swing arm bag, which is awesome. I love it. But that's it. And, you know, if you get like the Street Glide or something, at least you get the big old saddlebags on the side and the back, and you have plenty of storage space. And I mean, you can carry your swimming trunks and towel and food and lunch and all kinds of fun stuff in there. But yeah, this thing has no storage. Another thing is the engine gets super hot down here, and especially in the summer when you're sitting at red lights. I did buy the heat deflector shield, which helped, but it was $100. Thanks, Harley. I think they should come stock. You know, so there's lots of things that I like about the bike, and then there's nuances that I don't like. The stock seat is uncomfortable, super uncomfortable, which made me buy the two-up seat. I also had to install the rear passenger pegs, because if you're going to have the two-up seat, you might as well have the pegs, right? And then, you know, like I said, the heat. So it wasn't comfortable. It looked good. It's got that classic bobber style with the chopped fenders, which is why I like it over a lot of other Harley-Davidson bikes. But there are those nuances where you just, you know, there's little things if they just had this. And that's what I'm looking for, guys. So let me know in the comments below, do I sell this beautiful 2016 Harley-Davidson Softail Slim with barely 1,600 miles on it? Or do I take it, ship it across the Pacific Ocean, take it to where I'm moving next? Don't forget to guess which state in the comments below. I will reveal it in May, guys, so don't worry. I'm moving in that May-June time frame. And let me know also in the comments, do I keep it, do I sell it, or do I do something else? I don't know. You guys let me know. But yeah, guys, I'm really looking for your support and help. I'll also, on my Instagram, leave a poll. You know, should I keep it or sell it? And just to reiterate, I'm just thinking about selling it because I don't know if I want to take the risk of getting it damaged and paying for the shipping all the way back to the mainland. I love this bike, but you know, my heart and soul's not into it. It's comfortable. It looks awesome. It's bad. You know what I mean? Bad looking, bad and cool. But guys, let me know. Or do you love this bike and do not sell it? It's brand new. You know, it's still worth a lot, guys. It's just a fact, do I want the hassle of shipping two bikes? So guys, you've heard both sides of my story, things I love about this bike and the things that kind of need to be improved, but I've kind of improved them, such as getting the two-up seat, the heat deflector shield, which is right here, and I got the passenger pegs. Everything else is stock on this bike, actually, guys. The pipes look good. They sound good. I thought about getting some Vanson Hines, like the fork tongue snake style ones that come down, but I don't see the need, guys. But yeah, we'll just do a quick walk around of this thing. I mean, it's good, guys. I love it. You know, I also added this crash bar here. I just think it makes it look a little cool. Got the bobber fenders, the classic Hollywood style handlebars, the cat eye console. I mean, there's a swing arm bag that I bought, guys, for storage, which isn't much, but you know what I mean. It also has the heel-toe shifter, which I love. It's super comfy. You got bobber in the back right there. That's pretty much it. So, guys, please let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Let me know if I should keep this bike or should I sell it. If I keep it, I got to ship it all back to the mainland across the ocean. And I got two bikes, of course, but you know, those are always the thought of if I get the money from this bike by selling it, what's going to be waiting on the other end. So let me know in the comments below what you think I should do. Also check out my Instagram and leave me a little note on there on what you think I should do with the bike, guys. Also, what state am I moving to? Let me see your guesses down below. Let's see who gets this thing right. So other than that, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please give a big old thumbs up. Those help me out, all those likes. Let's see if we can get to 100 likes. You know, subscribe to this channel if you haven't. all the support you guys provide me keeps me motivated to keep making these videos, because, you know, all my videos got demonetized by YouTube because I didn't hit the 4,000 mark or whatever for the year, but I'm pretty close. I'm at like 3,900 hours, guys. So with that, y'all take care. Let me know your comments below on your thoughts on this beautiful motorcycle. Again, a 2016 Harley-Davidson Softail Slim. Let me know if I should keep it or not. And until next time, I'll talk to y'all later. Aloha. Damn.